Hi everyone, I'm Vandana Rai from Immigration Advisors New Zealand, and I'm making this video for all onshore student visa holders because I'm getting a lot of questions on whether it's okay for them to stay on the visa that they've got extended from INZ. There could be changes in their circumstances. So I will try and cover most of the questions that I'm getting. So the first question that I'm usually getting is, I've got this visa auto extended by Immigration New Zealand till September, end of September 2020. However, I won't be studying the course that my visa has. So I was initially doing a level 5 program and I was supposed to go into and complete my level 6 now. However, the visa that I've got has the same conditions. What am I required to do? So for my answer to all the students who finished their first program and they were supposed to do higher level diploma, I would convey this to all students that you need to apply for your new visa immediately. The reason immigration has granted this visa extension automatically is to make sure that you do not get unlawful because of this pandemic. The purpose of the visa extension is to maintain your lawful status. However, if there are changes to your conditions, you need to apply for a visa. Just to elaborate, if you've got a visa for a level 5 program, which is got auto extended and the same conditions remain, that means you can only study a level 5 program. So if you try and study a level 6 program on the same visa, firstly, your education provider would not allow that. Secondly, if that gets missed at any level, it could also mean that you are in breach of your visa condition because your visa is for a level 5 program, whereas you're trying to enroll for a level 6 program. So please get your visa changed. You would have to apply for another student visa to be able to change the conditions on your visa. So the second question which I get in a similar situation is, then what do I do? Do I apply for a new student visa or do I apply for a variation of condition? So my answer to that question is really depends on the length of the course that you would be studying. So when you apply for a variation of condition, only the conditions get changed. However, the end date of your visa would not get changed. So if you would be studying a new program and the new program would end before September 2020, then fine, you can do a VOC, a variation of condition. However, if you feel that your new program is a 30 weeks program, is a year long program, not likely to finish by September 2020, then in all circumstances, you must apply for a new student visa. Another question that I'm getting from students enrolled in the universities, especially the University of Auckland, they are in a situation where anybody who's enrolled for a master's program, if you have not got the required CGPA, you are not allowed to continue with your master's program. So in the university, if you're enrolled for a master's program, I'm talking of international students, you need to have a B grade average with your course. If you don't have a B grade average, the university kind of gives you these instructions to either exit with a postgraduate certificate if you've studied 60 credit points program till now, or they would tell you to exit with a PG diploma if you've till now studied a 120 credit program. Or they would tell you to apply for a visitor visa, or you need to change into a master's program or any other program that you would want with any other university. So I would just like to spread this word to all uni students. If you've got yourself in a similar situation, because I am aware that the results have recently been declared, and there are a few of you who've not managed, unfortunately, to get the required B grade average, the required CGPA to continue with your master's program. You would need to decide what you want to do. You may need to apply for a visitor visa immediately, or you would like to decide what would you like to study now. Why I would say is many of you are not aware of the consequences that this can have. So you came here on a student visa with a master's as one of your conditions, and you get a certificate from the uni which says a postgraduate certificate, As a result, you would not be eligible for a post-study work visa if you don't continue into your intended program. Please contact all the students. If you are in a similar situation, please contact and probably we can advise you on what would be the best possible way out for you, either to continue your program into any other university. If the intake for the university is ahead, a few months down the line, probably getting into a visitor visa, so you are not considered to be in breach of your visa conditions. What are the implications of exiting from the uni program with a different program, different from what you had the first student visa initially for? So please do contact us. Any other query if you have pertaining to student visas onshore, because I am aware that at times students don't even realize that they need to do something. There could be few situations where they would need to do some things differently. Please do contact and I'll try and help you whichever way possible. Thank you so much.